Hello all, I hope you have a good time and thank you for coming to my channel. Today I want to do a little video, short one, to do follow up on that serie where I create a landing page on different page builder. And today I wanted to talk about Gutenberg, and more precisely Gutenberg with an additional plugin. In this case, it's Kadence Blocks Pro. The reason why I use Kadence Blocks Pro is because, first of all, I'm part of the ones, and I know not everybody agree on that, but I'm part of the ones that believe that Gutenberg itself is not necessarily enough, not there yet. And to take more advantage of it, we need to have a few add-ons to it, one or more add-ons to it. And one of the best from what I've seen and what other people that use Gutenberg are saying is that Kadence Blocks is one of the best. So by the way, Gutenberg Blocks, WordPress Blocks is the same thing. It's just that Gutenberg is an additional plugin, by the way, but since it was the name since before WordPress 5.5, we sometimes still call it Gutenberg. So anyway, this is the page that I've built. This video will be a little bit different in that I don't show you all the process because I did it just once. Usually I do it once or twice to practice, take notes, and then I redo it while doing the video. In this case, I didn't do that because it was, honestly, I'm not too used to Gutenberg, so it was a little bit painful for me, to be quite honest. I don't know all the ins and outs of Gutenberg, so that's the reason why. So, little disclaimer here. Almost everything, except a couple of things here and there, are Kadence Blocks. So Kadence Blocks Pro here. So there are a couple of exceptions with simple text here and there, but most of them, this one seems to be a regular text, but most of them are, even the text like this one is an advanced text from Kadence, because I wanted to make sure that I have all the settings like the margin and so on. We have way more settings in Kadence Block than we have, of course, for Gutenberg alone. And that's one of the reasons why I'm not a Gutenberg fan. Still, I had a little hard time to make it work the way I wanted, the full width and so on, but I was able to do so. So you can see that the page looks exactly the same with Gutenberg Block, with Kadence Blocks Pro, using Gutenberg, then all the others that I did with the other page builder. So yes, I can achieve the same design using that. So first thing. So just to make sure. Okay. Now, the big question is, how does it perform? Development time, like I said, I didn't redo it, so I cannot compare really on that. I was slow, honestly, but that's because I don't know that tool enough. That's the only reason. But what is the score? Remember, this is on the same server as the latest one that I did on Bricks and Breakdance. So exact same multi-site installation. So it does have, and I think I disabled it for the testing, but it does have item security, but didn't change the score anyway. So GT Metrics, you see 96 and 97. And I know that some people, by the way, will have 100. That's simply the speed of my server. That probably slows things down a little bit, sorry. But that's okay, because if that one would be 100%, that means that the others, like Bricks and Breakdance and the others that I did before, would be 100% as well. So it will be a little bit harder to differentiate one and the other. So you can see that, surprisingly, I was expecting 99 to 100%. And surprisingly, it performs about the same thing as all the other three that I mentioned, Bricks, Breakdance, and the latest one that I did was Elementor with the new container build and so on. All about the same score, plus or minus 1% or something like that. So, conclusion here for me. If, like me, you were tempted to go to Gutenberg for the sole reason, the only reason, that you were told that it's faster than a page builder, well, then think again. You see that the scores are about the same. Now, I'm not saying that Gutenberg is bad. I'm not saying, of course, that Kadence Blocks is bad. And maybe Kadence Blocks here adds a little bit of weight to Gutenberg alone, of course, but it adds a lot of, removes a lot of pain, let's say, when using it. But it's about the same thing. So if the only reason why you were thinking about using Gutenberg is speed, performance, then you don't have to do it. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to stick with Page Builder for now anyway. If you go with Gutenberg for other reasons, whether it be because you don't want to have another theme or plugin, like Bricks is a theme, whether it be because you think that the users will have it easier with Gutenberg or things like that, that's okay. If you want to go that route, of course. But the only thing that I'm saying is if the only reason you were going toward Gutenberg was speed and performance, then think again. You see, you have the exact same thing. And for my needs, the other page builder are way faster to use, way easier to use than this tool. Anyway, for me, of course, I'm not that used. If, by the way, the reason you use Gutenberg or Blocks, if you prefer, is because it's easier for the user, then, well, I have a couple of arguments against that. Not against in the sense that I'm against you do that, but in the sense that that might not be a good enough reason. First of all, most of these clients, if you hand them the site and if they make the modifications themselves, of course, that's the scenario I'm talking about here. Most of the time, they will only do posts. And anyway, 99% of the time, you will use Gutenberg for posts anyway, even if you use a page builder. So page builder will be used to create the pages, but posts will be made with Gutenberg. So that's not an argument for me. Second, some tools like Oxygen integrate directly with Gutenberg. They have an add-on and it works hand in hand with a Gutenberg. Some others, like for example, Elementor, Bricks, and so on, you can create a template for the entire page and then you just put the content in the middle of the page. And the content will be, of course, most of the time, a Gutenberg article or page. Post or page, sorry. Article is in French. So this is not a reason not to use a page builder again. Of course, if it's not to use other tools, then that's okay. Beside that, of course, for me, page builders are easier to use for me. And I think even for my clients, it's going to be easier, for example, and I know that you might argue with that, but I feel that Elementor is easier to use than Gutenberg, for example. So for a client that wants to create a page, maybe not just modify an editor because you can change role and they can only edit, but if they create a whole page, I believe that Elementor is easier to use. You might disagree, of course, and that's okay if you disagree. You're perfectly welcome to disagree with me, but I'm just saying again, my main point here is if you are looking at Gutenberg and one of the many add-ons it has, like Kadence Blocks in this case, just because it is faster, then it's not the case anymore. So, hope you enjoyed this video. Of course, your comments are welcome below that video. And if you liked it, put a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. It will help me to know what type of video you like. And of course, don't be afraid to exchange with me. I'm really happy to read you and to reply to you when I can. So thank you and have a good day.